Yo everyone, what up? Welcome back to Top Tier Cave. My name is Steve, and we're back in the apartment in the spare bedroom where we house the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles pinball. So in this Top Tier Tech video, we're going to start with part one, which is restoring the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles pinball. We're going to be replacing and swapping out the DMD, the 128x16 mini DMD, which only 5 games use, which is Ninja Turtles, Checkpoint, Hook, Star Trek Next Generation, and Daddy's the Batman. So when the seller sold me this, I knew full well that the DMD didn't work. So he cut me a break to give me a lesser price. Now we're going to switch it out. So here's my thought process. If I replace the power supply, then if I got a replacement normal DMD with the orange, it might work. Then another idea was if I just forget the power supply, which is missing the high voltage, which I'll check in a second with you, I'll show you. I get a LED version of the orange, and that fixes it for a lesser price, or go something with color, which I've wanted, because in the future I want all my games, hopefully, to have a color DMD or some sort of color variation. So the Ninja Turtles uses a green with a green film over it, so it fits the game's theme. And that's what I've done. So I've contacted Boston Pinball, which have been amazing. Jim, if you guys are watching, thank you. Very cool. I've contacted them on Pinside. He said, Steve, we're a little behind because they sold out, but I can make one for you, kind of a special order and a favor because I needed this. I wanted to get this out of the way. He sent it to me. It was a fair price. They've been professional and quick, and I'm very excited. And now I have the green 128x16 color DMD. So I've removed the back glass just to kind of speed things up a little. Now I'm gonna take you really quick to show you why this doesn't work. So let me pick you up and kind of just do this handheld here. So I do have the manual, and what's happening, if you can see here, let me just make sure this will, there we go. All right, so do you see this right here? See the 120, the plus 128? When I check that on the multimeter, it's like plus 6. And I'm like, what the hell is that? So what I'll do is I'm going to set you up now strategically in position. I'll just show you quickly what's happening. And if this happens to your game, you would know, because you would know if the power supply is not putting out this voltage or if the mini DMD is gassed out. Now, the truth is, it's very possible, it's very possible that this DMD did work, but the power supply wasn't giving out the plus 28. So like a dumbass klutz, this wasn't broken. I went to actually remove this because I wanted to see the measurements, and I don't know why, I was just tinkering with it, and I grabbed one of the legs off a solder, and it fell. And it fell on this and broke the screen. Now, it's not all lost because we're going to have to pull the ROM for the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles on the new DMD. But it's a shame because I maybe could have sold this or anyways. So it's too far gone. The only good thing that came out of that is a little fire under my ass to say, look, I need a replacement. I feel stupid. And this is the catalyst of doing that. So something came from nothing. So we're there. Fair price. Here's the new color DMD. I'll show you guys very quickly. Now, it came beautifully wrapped in a static-free bag. Came with the instructions. I'll just show you quick. That's the bottom part of it. So we're going to follow the instructions, which they've sent very well. I already had the ROM, which I'll show you. And if you ever do get a replacement for this, you can request it from Boston Pinball or take it from your old game or buy it online. So I'm going to set you up in a sec. I'll show you why, you know, what the voltage is. If you ever have this issue, you can self-diagnose it just because of as a tutorial. And then once we do that, we're going to take it step by step, very slowly, to install this because we only got one shot, and I'm going to be super careful not to drop it and break it, because if I do, this damn thing's going off the balcony. I don't give a shit. So, and that's a far way down. So with that being said, let me set you up. Let's test the voltages just so I can show you guys. It's my first time working on the pin. If I'm doing something wrong, comment and correct me in the comments, and hopefully this works because I'm really excited. Okay, so what I've done is open the back box. And so you have to leave, I'm going to turn the game on in a second. I've taken the power from the DMD, so that's there down. You leave in the ribbon cable. I'm going to power up the game now. So then what we're going to do, we're going to, on the multimeter, if you guys can see, we're going to put it to 200. Beautiful. I'm going to take ground from here. I remove the speaker box. And then if you can see on the manual that we just saw, the plus 64 volt is the violet. So we're going to look at the violet, which is right there, which is the fifth in. And we'll do that. As you can see, it's getting damn near nothing. Again, it's getting one volt. Let's see the other ones. Yep, so, you know, the 5 volts, you know, working. That's ground. So everything seems to be okay, except, you know, the 12 volts is at 16. Apparently that's okay. So you can see the one, it's at 1 or 1.3. Which is wrong. It should be, that should be plus 67 as far as what I'm told. So no good. No good there. So that's how you check it. Again, put your multimeter, ground it, put it on the violet, and that should be 64. So that's what's happening, and that's why the game is, the DMD is not lining up. So let's turn this off. So that's why the DMD is not lining up, and that's what we need. Now, let's take this and get organized. Now again, I'm not very techy. This is my first tech video with pinball, so I'm taking it one step at a time. And if I'm really slower, you're like, come on Steve, do this, I'd rather be safe than sorry, because believe me, I've been burned in the past with this hobby, so yeah, never again. All right, so what I've done is just covered the glass with a blanket. This blanket I actually used to cover the game when it's dormant, and not being played because of the sunlight. You can see it's my apartment is sun drenched, and I don't want it to kill the artwork because I have wiped down the sides and they're in really, really good shape. So let me quickly unplug the game just in case. Even though the power switch is off, I don't trust shit. All right, so what we're gonna do, let's remove the old DMD. So let's take this off. We'll need that for later. Now, this is when, so then there's little clips here, so you just pinch them in. Pinch them in and remove. Shit. Well, it should be. This is how I screwed it up. Believe it or not, oh, it's out. There. So what happened was, when I was removing this, I don't know what the hell I was doing. I think I was trying to look at the... Anyways, I'm like, oh, cool. And then it caught my finger and then went boom. And then I was... I'm not going to lie, I almost cried. All right, so that's been removed. That's been removed. And then let's lay the old one here. Let me get the new one. You guys see? Yep. All right. So let's get the new DMD. Now, there's going to be parts of this video I'm going to be very quiet, only because I want to concentrate, because I really don't want to screw this up. All right, so the new DMD. All right, beautiful. So here's the instructions, which we'll read together. And then here's the static-free bags. Again, thank you, Boston Pinball. You guys have been amazing so far. And all right, and then, so that paper is only to cover the green film. I'll leave that on for now. And we'll just set the box down nice and easy. All right. So, this is what the marquee looks like. Excuse me, the DMD looks like. Right there, Boston Pinball. There's the green film. It even says right there, for use. Now, what you'll notice, let me just quickly get in here. Where is it? Ah. It actually even shows that there's no high voltage. Let me get in here. Let's see if you guys can see it. Do you see right there? Now, normally it would say 5 ground key 12 plus 68 and then 1, what was it, 128? I can't remember now. Where's the manual? Actually, it's right here. Yeah, it would say... plus 68, minus 98, minus 100. It doesn't say that because these new DMDs with LEDs do not use that. It uses the, I guess, the 5 and the 12 volt, which is awesome. So now I don't have to hopefully rebuild that power supply. So Doug was telling me, which is our, you know, our tech within our group. There's others, but he's the one that's been kind of walking me through it, saying, Steve, you know, to rebuild that power supply would be around $75 with parts, give or take, with labor. And he would help me out with it, of course. Or I'd buy a new one for $200 Canadian shipped. And anytime I speak money, it's going to be shipped with Canadian dollars. Any American that's watching, minus 35% off that. That's what our shit dollar's at. So let's read the instructions. I've read them before. So first, what we're going to do is remove the old display, which I've done. Make note of pin one on the ribbon cable. So the reason being, there's the red. Let me get in. You see that? There's the red. So when we plug it in, we'll make sure, and it even labels it, which is beautiful. You see right there? Red wire right there. If I put it backwards, I suspect I'm going to blow it, and I would cry and shit my pants. So looking at this again, so we're going to remove that. I don't think we need spacers. It did come with them. They're like little, almost like leg levelers, but I think these are, maybe these weren't in the other ones, but this looks to be okay because they're the same height. So I'm going to try to get away with using these ones because they work very well. And then what we're going to do is take this ROM, that one right there, which is game proprietary, move this, and this is a 28 pin. So you know it speaks of the 28 pin. Whoop. When it speaks of the 28 pin, it's that, it's the Ninja Turtles, and you can see, watch the notch, and then hook has 32 pin, which goes all the way. So that's where it's going to go. Now I assume, so it's interesting because this one is vertical. So then I assume the chip would be like that, which will be like that. So like there. So I'm going to double check that just to make sure. God, my God, help me. I don't want to screw this up. I really, really don't. And so either way, so with that, maybe I'll just double check, maybe do some online research, but hopefully it'll work. And then blah, 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 move forward, and then spacers. Now this is neat. So then what you would do is install this. So this is the red is the 5 volt. So that's 5 volt, which would go there. So, and we'll line that up, and then ground, 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 because the yellow is ground at the end right there. So hope I'm kind of making sense here. And then the cool thing is you see these, you can remove these settings, removing these little jumpers right here, which are, where are they? Oh, right here. It actually even says brightness control, remove jumpers. So I'm gonna, as long as I get picture, we'll turn it off, remove one, turn it off, remove one. The game's not complete yet restored. And I would, even though apparently this is supposed to be for the life of my machine, I might as well just keep it at a lower intensity until I actually get everything up and running and in the best condition. So I'm gonna set you up. I hope that was a good understanding of what I'm gonna be doing. Get to familiar with the Boston Pinball new power supply. Excuse me, the new DMD, mini DMD. And we're going to carefully remove. First, I think what I'm going to do is remove that the chip first. Make sure all the legs are not bent and straight. And then from there, we'll hopefully do our little research, install it right there. Maybe this way, so it reads Ninja Ninja Turtles, which makes sense, right? And then from there, we should be good to go. We'll plug it in and cross our fingers. So let me set you up. All right, so everything is set up. So what I've done is I've covered the Boston Pinball display, not to touch that. Everything is removed. So let's go through the steps to make sure. So number one was remove the old display from the speaker panel. I have A, no pin one on the ribbon cable is red. Should be red. The hell? The red wire should be pin one. If not, mark your mark it to identify pin one. So we've identified the red is pin one. That is good. Next, save the hardware, which normally I guess would be the screws, but it has these already. C would be remove the 4 spacers on the stubs. So I've removed that, and again, I'm going to leave this in and see if I can use it. So that was D. So remove this. Excuse me. That was one ABC done. So 1D is carefully remove the display ROM chip from old display, which is that. And it says TMNT. I don't know, what is that? A104. The hell if I know what that says. So screwdriver. Let's quickly, or the flathead. I'm gonna slowly do this on each side. Normally I like to use, I'm just going in and twisting lightly on each side while lifting at the same time. Good. And a little on each. Okay. So that went very smooth. Let me move this here. Can you guys see? You guys can't see shit, can you? Because it's on perfect focus. So everything looks to be okay. One of the legs, let me just bend back a little. Bend back a little, very, very slowly. All right. So I'm bending the legs back ever so slightly. They're almost exactly perfect. Almost. Let me actually get that screwdriver and just space them very slowly. They look damn near perfect. Okay. Actually, there's a way I can undo this. There we go. It's terrible, isn't it? So that looks pretty straight. All right, so all the legs are ready. They're pretty clean, I suppose. Now, if I had, I don't have, and I should, I did want a fiberglass eraser, which is always a good idea to put there, a deoxid, but I do not. So hopefully that's okay. So next, take the ROM chip and make sure the pins are straight, which you've done. So that was number two. A, install the ROM chip in the ROM socket in the new display. So this old display, I'm gonna put aside in the box that the new one came in. So let's keep organized. Let's move that there. Neatly out of the way. So let's move now the new display forward. Beautiful. Okay, so you guys can see that. So take the ROM chip and make sure the pins are straight. A, install the ROM chip in the ROM socket in the new display. If you have a 28-pin ROM, be sure to line up the chip at the back end so that there are four open pins at the front end. So yeah, and that's the 28-pin. So TMNT has a 28-pin, and you can see four are remaining. So 28 plus 4 would be 32 on hook, but Ninja Turtles has 28. So what I'm going to do is take the ROM. Oh shit, where did it go? Oh, here. So here's what I'm going to do. You see how there is on this paper, that's where the ROM, I guess it has the printed, the details, and then it's in line. So I'm going to take that, so that and that, and I assume that the back of it is here. So just like that. So I'm going to be very careful. Again, I'm going to be very quiet. So again, the back is left. I assume the back is left here and leave four. So I'm going to be very quiet. Actually, where's that? I'm going to have to press it down here. Again, guys, I'm going to be very quiet. I'm just putting it in and lining up all the feet, all the legs. Now, if I fast forward this, it's only because I'm taking my time here. So, yeah, you have to be very careful to line up the legs here. Some of them are not 100%. Let me just bend these back. All right, everyone, so we're back. Whew, that took a good 15 minutes. That's very tight. That's actually very scary. There's been times, like when I was doing it, there was times, I bent the leg a little too far back, and it was actually very worrisome. It's very tight, very, very tight, because I guess it's a new socket, right? So it took, I didn't want to put too much force, but it took a lot. So I'm going to just get my cell. I hope that looks, let me put this straight. Damn, that was a little scary. Whew.
Very scary. Yeah, I had to take it off camera. I was swearing a lot. All right, so every pin looks to be in. Boom, 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 boom. I hear the little snap go, not the snap, but the, you know, that little part, you know, that little sound that all the legs go in. That was a terrible sound effect, I know. All right, and then let's look at this side. Shit. Looks to be okay. I went over like 5 times. Because it's hard to press it like this, because on this side is the DMD, and it's glass. So you're like, ooh, and then you're hearing kind of like stress sounds. I'm like, oh, shit. But it did, I pressed it down, and I heard that little when it went in. I hope that's good. I really do. Okay. So, let's turn the cell off here. Okay. So far, you know what? I'm going to, maybe I'll keep that light on. I'll just leave it there. Who cares? All right. So, next. So let's make sure we did it right. See that notch? Notch is on the right. Notch is on the right. So these letters on the left. Letters on the left. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Notch. Notch. Make sense? Make sense. Okay. So that part was a little scary. So 28 pin ROM, there should be 4 pins vacant. 1, 2, 3, 4 vacant. Good. Very well. Okay, next. So 28, that's in. So if you have a 28, blah, 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 done. Install the 4 new longer spaces on the studs. No need for checkpoint. Now, this should be good enough. I really do believe. Because there's no hardware, like it's saying. So maybe the other version had one. I don't know. Install the display onto the standoffs and I don't have those, that's fine. So those are those standoffs, I assume. I don't have nuts. Install the ribbon cable and power cable. So very vital. Let's go back to one. Make sure no pin red wire. So let's set you up and let me do it. I'm doing this live. Oop, right over here. Let me just angle you down here. I wouldn't be so worried if the part wasn't so expensive and harder to get, because Jim had actually special order this and he's not going to make new ones until the fall. So right now we're in June and I want this up and running. Anyway, so we're recording, yeah? Yeah, okay. All right, so let's follow the instructions. So install the display, no need. Install the ribbon. Okay, so let's now, a little sweaty. Let's move this up. All right. So first thing, let me actually just put this here. Okay. So let's do this. Boston Pinball. Hopefully everything goes well. So far, everything lines up. I heard the little clip. Heard the clip. Is anything touching? Oh, maybe. Because there's some capacitors that are. Or is this on? No, these are not on. Shit. So the capacitors are touching. Yeah. So this is one for the books. How the hell am I going to do this now? Because those spacers. Shit. Shit! Oh, fuck off. Leave me alone. Come out. I don't want this to fall. It's stuck. nice and easy, no harm done. Alright, so now I do need the spacers because, damn it, I might have to do this off camera and show. These capacitors are touching. They're too snug, which makes sense because these little feet, unless do these go here? Well, that won't make sense because where the hell is the screws? Huh. Well, I'm gonna have to figure this out. All right, so dilemma, slight dilemma. These don't work. These capacitors are touching too, they're too tight. So now I'm gonna figure out how the hell, because I don't have hardware, how I'm gonna put these in. Are these screws? What the hell? I don't know what these are. Are these screwed in? All right, I'll be back and see what's going on here. All right, so I had to take a quick break there to understand the relevance of these and how it works. So here's what I found out. I've just read the instructions and I removed the spacers. So I removed this part. I removed that, and then it was like a wood screw. And I'm like, well, that's weird. What the hell? So the only thing I can figure out is I put the washer, like I put the spacer on it. Let me give you an example. Let me get one. Okay. So what I did is I just put this in. Trying to one-hand this. Yeah, like that. So I put it in, and you can hear it's pretty snug. The one thing I didn't understand is, I'm like, wait a minute, what the hell? How is it supposed to hold, and will it touch the glass? Because remember, the back glass comes on. I think it should be okay. So I have one more there. Now, before I put that on, I have some, like, this is just for my arcade parts. I just random shit in here, and And this was a spacer from one of my PCB feet. And sometimes if the PCB was a dual, you would add this. I'm like, ah. Now I'm a little lucky. Oh, shoot, where did I put them? All right, there's one. Put them here. So I had a screw here, and I only have three of them. Because these are not even supposed to, like, I just accidentally put them in this little tool kit here. So I did practice on the broken one, and I had to hold it down, like I had to do this. I had to hold that and then screw it in with that, and it actually worked. Truth be told, they were a little big, but I think we can get away with it. It's going to be good because there's the thin, DMD. So that's what I'm going to do. Now, the only thing is I only have three, but I think it should be snug enough. And then I'll find one or go to the hardware store or leave it. I'll find one anyways. I like that to complete the fourth. So it was a little wearisome. I'm like, what the hell is going on? So Boston Pinball Gym, if you're watching, please include or maybe not assume that we all have because it's not on my game. Anyways, not a big deal. I mean, I was just lucky I had the part. So other than that, it's been going so far so good. It freaked me out. So, okay, let's do it. So let's put on this last spacer. And again, that's from just knowing because I had the, again, on the PCB, that's on my arcade. I think it came from my Street Fighter 2. All right, so let's do this. Now, here's the game plan. Actually, before I do that, let me just get the DMD. Well, let me remove this. So now it's saying install it for new longer on the studs and then install the display onto the standoffs. Oh, attach with nuts. I don't have those nuts. I don't have the nuts associated. So maybe a different version came with nuts. Mine didn't. Good thing I have. I have three of them. So yeah. So okay. So we're on the same kit. We're on the same page. The nuts did not come onto my kit. Now it's possible that because I asked, it was a special request,
and Jim was not working on them, and he did this as a special type of request and order for me, that he may have missed them. No problem. I was just worried. Anyway, so let's get, we're at number five. We're almost done. Another couple steps. Install the display on the new standoffs and attach with nuts. So, I'm going to keep you live here. Maybe I'll just do one or two, and then I'll cut away to all of them except one being there. So maybe I'm going to do one, two, because that's where the hardware, like that's where the ribbon and the power is, and then there's less weight here, so one and more support the weight. That kind of makes sense, right? So I'm going to put two here, one on the top, and leave this one at the moment unscrewed. So let's get organized. Okay, so there's the DMD. I'll remove this this film. You know what this reminds me of? You know when you go to the barber and they put that like that static that goes around your neck for the hair? Anyways. All right, let me get the hardware. So I'm gonna be very careful because now there's a DMD involved. Should I get my chair? See what happens when you're shorter? Outrageous. All right, so let's get my tools right here. All right, very carefully. Damn, I wish my wife was here to hold this, but. All right, let's try to do this one-handed very carefully. So everything so far, okay. All right, so that fits in very well. That in or what? All right, let's carefully do this. I have shaky hands, that doesn't help. It's going in or what? I guess so. Maybe I should get it. See, I'm right-handed, so this is I don't want to put that pressure on and scratch anything. I'm going to be very quiet and I may even cut away.
All right, so let me give you, it's been a few minutes. Actually, not even. This is on tight, as you can see, tight. Here's the one that's missing a screw, but as you can see, let's just get that zoomed. Come on. There we go. There's barely any play here, so that's good. That's more than okay. Again, I will find a screw just to do it lightly. So let's now open the back. Beautiful. So right there. I'm getting caught up here. So right there is where the power, and then right there is where the ribbon is. Oh, I guess the power is right in the middle. Anyways, both. So either way. All right. So what I'm going to do now, let me set you up behind me one moment. So far that's snug. Let me set you up behind me. Try to strategically do this. Plug in the power. So here's the game plan. See how it said red wire? You see that? So that's going to go in like this, red wire. Actually, let me take you off the tripod here. Okay. Let me get you in. See how it said red wire right there? Let me try to get my... Right there, red wire. That goes there. So this... Where's the camera here? That goes in like that, red wire to the left. And then... Where's that? Where the hell's the power? Oh, here. And then this, so you see the 5 volt. 5 volt is the red, and then left is ground, I assume. Yes, it is right there. So red, and then blue is going to be 12 volt. Beautiful. All right, so it's going to go in like this, and then we're going to plug it in. So let me put you behind me, so let's get organized.
All right, so let's do that. Just get some exposure there. Oops, it's a little too high. All right, so here we go. Okay, let's focus. So, install the ribbon. Okay, beautiful. Install the ribbon and power cables. Let's do ribbon first. So, red to the left like we just did, red to the red, right there. Red, red. Beautiful, that went on very smoothly. Okay, beautiful, red and red. Now, so just like this, red to the right, plus five, and then ground here. Okay. All right, snapped beautifully in. Okay. Hopefully these spaces aren't too big. I don't know, will the glass fit? I hope so. If it does, I have no idea. So anyways, right, so you can see, just so I don't screw it up, red plus five to the right, ground, ground, no high voltage, ground, ground. And then red wire. Okay, let's put the speaker box back. Beautiful. Oh shit. Oh, is it getting caught or what? Well, does speaker go first or speaker go after? No, speaker goes. Okay, speaker first, move these very nicely, like that. Okay, let me show you. As you can see, that's all nice and tight. Take the autofocus off, there we go. That's nice and tight, that's nice and tight. We did it together, everything looks right. Let's remove this. So that's removed, but we'll keep it where the old DMD is, just in case. Okay, let's set you up one last time. Everything looks tight, everything looks right. Let's look at the instructions. Install the display on the stand up. Beautiful. Install the ribbon power. Yes. Turn on the machine and observe the display. A. The display has 5 brightness settings. It's shipped to the lowest settings to increase the brightness. Remove jumper 1 at a time till the 4th position desired. Okay, makes sense. So let's just see if it works. All right, so here we go. Everything's connected. You know what? Before I turn this on, I was just kind of looking at how this is going to sit. There's no way the glass is going to fit. Something's up. I don't know if something's up with these spacers. I think they're too big because it just doesn't make sense. When I did them before, it doesn't fit. Now they're too much. I don't understand. Maybe the spacers in this game is different. Either way, let me just make sure it works and I'll deal with that. That's not the biggest problem. So hopefully it works. So it's plugged in. I'm gonna turn it on, let's see what happens, and hopefully we have a running DMD, even if it's a little dim, that I already know to remove the jumper. Ready? 5, 4, 3, 2. Hey, welcome. Yeah! Yes, 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 guy! Hey, yo! Look at that. It's supposed to do that.
I don't know if it's supposed to flicker that, maybe, I don't know. So far, so good. So it looks like it'd be working. There we go, down in the sewers. Ha ha, she's tied up. Oh wow, I'm playing better on the side here than I would normally. Alright, so it works. Now what I'm gonna do is see if the glass installs, which I don't think it does. It's too close. Is it supposed to blink the score like that? No idea. Shit. Right, let me put it up close. That flickering is, you can actually, it's here too. I don't know if that's normal, but it works. It looks pretty cool. But again, that space, I don't think it's gonna reach. You know what, that display looks pretty good. I don't think I need it brighter than that for now. Alright, so let me stop it here. So far it's working, which is great. Let me see if I can put the glass on. If not, we're going to have to address these spacers because I don't understand now. Alright, so my wife's just helped me here hold this. As you can see, just have a pillow in case it falls. Trying to put it in the groove. Mary, come here. It won't fit, right? It's hitting?
What's hitting?
It's hitting the display right behind it. It won't fit. It won't sit properly. Alright, so watch it, but let me just move this glass very carefully. So here's what we've discovered. With those spacers, with these spacers on my game, it will not work. It's way too far out, as you just saw. So my wife and I carefully removed the spacers. Remember the original tabs here? It actually fits perfect. Now, it fits, but the, it fits, carefully do this, but these caps are snug. They're very snug against that, and I don't like it. I doubt it would do anything, but I want to give it a little slack, even like 2-3 millimeters. So here's what I've discovered. Based on the way it sits. So it sits like that. So these caps. Where are we here? Yeah. So these caps are hitting against this. So it look at it, there's room here where the wood, where I can just cut this cardboard thing where it's almost an inch. So then a couple of the caps can be free of any type of tight isolation. So what I'm going to do is, let's do this together. Get my X-Acto. I'm going to just cut it to the most I can. You actually see the bend. Very carefully. Good. Down. And I'm removing this. Very neat and tidy. I might as well do it on this side because now I have a little more slack for the cables. Now, it's not like you're going to be able to see behind it. Maybe that's what they were going for. Maybe I should leave it, but then again, what difference does it make? It's not like, oh, maybe for bleeding or anything. You know what? I'm going to leave the back part just in case. So let's try this again. So beautiful, beautiful, nice, ah shit. A little dirt there. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the existing clips. You got that, right? Yeah. I'm gonna use the existing clips, these,
They're tight. Put it back on and then put on that, and then we're gonna turn it on and make sure it actually is not that tight. All right, so what I've done is these spacers, man. So I've taken the spacers and put them on first, as you can see. Then what I'm gonna do, you know what, let's do it live. Let's do it. Now I'm gonna put it to the desired see, now they're not touching. So that's okay. The only thing is this steady? This one's in more. Right. All right, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna square it up, and then with the screwdriver, just put it out until it's all even, and then plug it in and take it from there. Because right there, see, I can't move it, and it's good enough because the glass is gonna be right there anyway. So it's not even when I'm shaking the game. Right there, it's perfect. And right now, I'm looking at it, it's not touching. So that's not touching, and I can see daylight. Oh, good. I can see daylight through the caps. I mean, another thing would be to just drill this whole thing out, but no, I'm not prepared to do that. All right, so I'm gonna just move these out little by little. Then once it's a little snug, I'll plug the cords in and I'll have it ready. Let's put that pillow here in case. All right. Damn thing. All right. So you chose www.bostonpinball.com. I may have to raise it up or move. All right, so glasses on. A little nerve wracking. I want to adjust it, but I'll do it off camera. So you have to play with it just the way it is. It says Boston Pinball right there. That's fine. Maybe it's for advertising, who knows? Are you gonna come or do you want me to try it?
Coming, one flat.
Alright, so my wife's gonna come, we're gonna try it together. Alright, so let me plug it in. Okay. I'm ready to flip the switch, let me turn the lights off. Where's that light coming from? Oh, the door. All right, close the door behind you. Close it. Like all the way. Like close it. All right, so let's do this. So it's plugged in. Watch the DMD. Recording. All right, here we go. Come on.
Hey, Mutant.
Yeah. Looks good to me. Yeah, it looks actually that Boston Pinball is supposed to be there, isn't it? Or is it a little low? You may have to raise it. Anyways, that's semantics. So there's already, who, you wanna play? Or you wanna record me? Okay, grab the camera. Cool. Ooh, shred. Well, all right, guys, there you have it. That was the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Part 1. The restore, removing, and swapping out the DMD. My pinball guys are laughing their ass off like, Steve, it took you 4 hours to do a DMD. Everything was easy. The only thing is I have to adjust the spacers because it's a little too low, and you can see the BostonPinball.com. I have to raise it up a little because it's starting to bleed through the LEDs. But again, I'll do that off camera. You got to just adjust it. It's working so far perfectly. I just want to make sure it's installed right, and then we can move forward. So this is part one. Part two, I'm gonna see what we're gonna do next. I'll wait. I have a few things in mind, especially the restoring of the play field, which I'll update you in the videos to come. So guys, it's been a pleasure. I thank you for checking out Top Tier. This is my first pinball video as far as a restore. If you want to subscribe, go ahead. We're just starting the turtles. The DMD looks tight. I gotta just adjust it. And so now I can actually go through the settings and see what I'm looking at. So again, thanks again for checking out Top Tier. Peace.